Have you ever watched a movie or TV show and wondered, how does that technology work? Is it even possible? Look, I don't pretend to know how Iron Man's suit or plugging into the Matrix actually works, but I know a blockchain when I see one. We can learn a lot from fictional tech and how it relates to the very real world of blockchains and cryptocurrencies. This is the Blockchains of Altered Carbon, presented by MarketSquare, the new homepage for the decentralized web. While watching the first episode of season 2, I saw a character reach into his jacket pocket and pull out a device. They called it
untraceable credits.
And you know what that is? A blockchain.
I still can't understand it.
More specifically, untraceable credits are a decentralized, quantum-proof, privacy-based stablecoin cryptocurrency.
Prove it.
And I'm going to prove it right now. So, in Altered Carbon, immortality and deep space colonization have become reality through a device called a DHF.
DHF.
It stores human consciousness, allowing people to change bodies at will and travel as beams of light between worlds.
I'm traveling. Interstellar.
That is, if they have the cash.
Show me the money!
We currently live in a world where the rich get richer. Extrapolate that over hundreds of years and throw immortality into the mix, and what you get is Altered Carbon, where the rich are basically unstoppable pharaoh gods called meths, a reference to the biblical figure Methuselah.
The cells in our bodies are constantly dying and being replaced. As we age, we become a copy of a copy of a copy, degrading each time.
Meths have got around that.
So let's think like a meth for a minute. What's the best way to store liquid wealth for hundreds of years in a multi-planetary society? Traditional fiat currencies such as US dollars are a bad move.
This is a bad idea.
Since there's no guarantee that the US dollar will preserve wealth for hundreds of years, or even exist in the year 2400. In fact, the inflation and fiscal policy for fiat currencies make them one of the worst store of value options out there for people who live hundreds of years.
That's too risky.
More and more money gets printed, devaluing the currency. Almost 20% of all US dollars in existence were created in 2020 alone.
I never heard that.
Hyperinflation in Venezuela hit 10,000,000% in 2019, according to CNBC. Inflation and the rise and fall of regimes make cash
unreliable.
I hate it. I'm out.
Another plan to store wealth for hundreds of years could be hoarding precious metals like gold.
I love gold!
After all, gold has been a sound choice for thousands of years already, right?
It stood unconquered for over 1,000 years.
But gold has its pitfalls.
Perhaps if you reminded me.
It's heavy, impractical for transactions, and it's expensive to store and keep safe, from Mark Wahlberg.
We got 4 minutes to load and leave. Let's go!
In Altered Carbon, humans have colonized dozens of worlds. Also, mining technique research is at its peak, because everyone's trying to mine rare elements that fuel DHF technology. They are literally digging immortality out of the ground, which is far more valuable than gold. For those reasons, gold may not be as valuable in Altered Carbon as we perceive it today.
What?
It would always remain unclear when the next gold-rich planet or asteroid will be discovered, devaluing gold further.
It's the size of Texas, Mr. President.
More importantly, you can't take gold with you when you needle-cast your consciousness to another planet.
Tell your boss, hard pass.
So, we need a solution that's resistant to both centralization and runaway inflation.
No matter what you have, it won't be enough.
We also need it to be digital, not physical.
How do you propose to do that?
That's what a cryptocurrency such as Bitcoin is.
We understand each other now.
Bitcoin is decentralized, which means the majority of the network must agree for any code changes to take place, making it extremely resistant to hyperinflation policies. Bitcoin is also provably scarce, which means that in the distant years where Altered Carbon is taking place, all Bitcoin is already in circulation, and more cannot be created. There will be no accidental discovery of more Bitcoins in some asteroid or planetary crust. The Bitcoins are in the computer.
They're in the computer.
They're in the computer?
So, does this mean that untraceable credits are actually Bitcoins? No. Especially since they literally put Bitcoin in the show. Bitcoin, Monero, Zcash, and Litecoin are all featured in Episode 5, according to this Bitcoin.com article. However, we can theorize that untraceable credits in the show are a cryptocurrency of some kind. because the future depicted in Altered Carbon appears to be cashless. That aspect of Altered Carbon aligns with the trajectory of today's world as well.
I don't believe you.
According to the New York Times, the novel coronavirus is accelerating progress towards a cashless society faster than usual. The article states that although 80% of European transactions involved cash, it's a fading routine for a growing number of people sensitized by COVID-19. The UK, China, and Sweden are already well ahead of the curve, with only 2% of Swedish transactions involving cash, as stated in a Core Cashless article. In the world of Altered Carbon, credits are the established currency.
And don't come crying to me when your credits go home in my pocket.
According to the research of this probably correct Reddit post, they are known as UN credits or United Nations credits. So we can think of credits as a type of global fiat superdollar. Here's the deal. One untraceable credit equals one credit. But one untraceable credit isn't technically a credit. If that's confusing to you, my friend James will break it down.
Same, same, but different, but still same.
This speaks to the concept of stablecoins. A stablecoin is a cryptocurrency designed to match its value to a fiat currency such as the US dollar or UN credits in the case of Altered Carbon. While Bitcoin's price rises and falls, stablecoins' prices remain constant.
What a refreshing change.
Some stablecoins are operated by registered business entities such as Coinbase or Gemini, two large cryptocurrency exchanges in the US. In this case, each unit of the stablecoin is backed by a real US dollar held in a bank account or an equivalent asset. These are called centralized stablecoins. But that's not untraceable credits. No.
Absolutely not.
Untraceable credits are a decentralized stablecoin. Computer code and free markets work in tandem to keep the decentralized stablecoin, well, stable. MakerDAO is one such system we know in today's world, which is responsible for the decentralized stablecoin called DAI, maintaining a loose peg to the US dollar.
I see.
So by now we have established that untraceable credits could very well be a cryptocurrency that is a decentralized stablecoin. Let's talk about privacy. After all, these credits are untraceable.
Untraceable credits.
Privacy coins in the world of cryptocurrency are already a thing. Examples include Monero, Zcash, Horizon, Beam, and Navcoin. A standard cryptocurrency such as Bitcoin is designed to be open and public, where all coins are visible in the system, and everyone who views the network can see where coins are going, coming from, and stored. But privacy coins are different.
This time feels different. That's what I'm worried about.
To protect user activity from public view, they obscure transactions and balances, or mask true activity with false activity. Recently, the FATF, or Financial Action Task Force, has been paying more attention to privacy coins by convincing US exchanges to start delisting them, according to this article from Crypto Slate.
I believe this brings your business here to a close.
Some people view privacy coins as a crime enabler, while others argue that they are necessary to preserve the freedom and rights of individuals. But transparent coins like Bitcoin have their strengths too. According to bitsofblocks.io, in 2019, Bitcoin played a key role in exposing a large criminal operation through its open ledger and, yup, you guessed it, blockchain. But hey, that's all just frosting on the cake. Since untraceable credits are untraceable, it's a privacy coin.
You have no proof.
No proof needed. QED.
How do you like them apps?
But they also gotta be quantum proof. You thought I forgot. Well,
you're wrong, Governor.
I know that it has to be quantum proof because hundreds of years of technological development pretty much guarantees that quantum computers have become as common as iPhones. Ew, gross. Androids. Go ahead, fight me in the comments. In Altered Carbon, not only have we advanced as a technological society over hundreds of years, but individuals now have the power to spend decades, centuries, the next word, eons, on their life's work. Imagine Elon Musk being able to create new technology for 400 years. So yeah, quantum computers are a thing in Altered Carbon. When we saw cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin, Monero, and Litecoin in Altered Carbon, it's safe to assume their blockchain code has already been upgraded to resist quantum attacks. Unfortunately, in our present time, blockchains are still vulnerable to the growing threat of quantum computing.
I have no idea what the hell you're talking about.
It's like a new Y2K, where instead of two missing digits in the year being the issue, how crazy was that?
Credit cards and ATMs may cease to function. Airplanes and trains may come to a halt.
It's a quantum computer in the wrong hands, which could easily hack any encrypted system we have today, including blockchains. Luckily, we all barely survived Y2K. Planes didn't fall out of the sky on midnight December 31st, 1999, and our AOL accounts and Tamagotchis were safe due to the hard work of engineers burning the midnight oil. Thank you, silent heroes.
I am invincible!
In today's world, this tradition of future-proofing continues as blockchain engineers design systems that can theoretically withstand quantum attacks. Nexus is one such example, which uses single-use keys and multiple concurrent consensus mechanisms to combat quantum attacks. QRL is another, which uses XMSS, a NIST-approved post-quantum secure digital signature scheme. So there you have it. Untraceable credits in altered carbon are a decentralized, quantum-proof, privacy-based stablecoin cryptocurrency. And now you know what that means.
Thank you. Good night.
Share this video with an altered carbon fan near you, so they too can see the light. Subscribe for more videos like this and to discover blockchain-powered projects and businesses on the video channel of MarketSquare, the new homepage for the decentralized web. See you next time.